super scientist today, we're going to do a science experiment called shrinking egg. And we're going to learn about what semi-permeability is. Here is our sheet that we will be using. So what you're going to do is put your name and date. The name of the science experiment is shrinking egg. The materials that you are going to use. So you're going to use the bubbling egg from our bubbling egg experiment that we did. So remember, the bubbling egg experiment was you take an empty mason jar like this, you take a raw egg like this, and then what you're going to do is you stick vinegar up to where it's covering the egg, and it takes 72 hours. So I had suggested starting this experiment on a Friday, and then you'll wait to see on Monday your egg. So you have a rubbery egg from the bubbling egg. So we're going to use the bubbling egg to do that. And then you're going to have corn syrup. This is corn syrup. So that's all you need, is the bubbling egg and then corn syrup. So you're going to draw your picture before. What happens before taking your bubbling egg, putting it in your mason jar, and then we're going to fill it with corn syrup so that it covers the egg. All right. So I've already done the experiment because this takes another 72 hours to do. So for example, if you use the bubbling egg on Monday, then by Wednesday-ish, Wednesday afternoon, maybe Thursday morning, you will have your shrinking egg. You're probably thinking, how can you take that really fat bubbling egg and shrink it just using corn syrup? Well, it's amazing what science can do. So this is what it looks like. I'm gonna show it up close. So here's the shrinking egg. Can you see it? Can you see how it's smaller? It shrunk. So it's really super, super cool. I wonder if I can take out. Ooh, it's gonna be really sticky because it's corn syrup, but we'll do it. Maybe we'll do it at the end so you can kind of see what it looks like up close. I'll do that. But so let's talk about, what is semi-permeability? What does that mean? Well, our egg right here is a matter. That's what, you know, you have substances. And so egg is a matter. We talk about how we have different forms of matter. We have a solid, a liquid, and a gas. So egg is a matter. And so the corn syrup, what happens is, remember we have our bubbling egg. It's full of liquid from the vinegar. The liquid soaked into it made it expand. It's a really big bubbling egg. So what happens is there's all this water inside that bubbling egg. And so after 72 hours with that egg inside the corn syrup, what happens is the reason why the egg shrinks is because the water is coming out of that egg. That's what's happening. So that is what is making the egg shrink, is the water is coming out. But I really want to show you, corn syrup's really, really sticky, you guys. So I'm gonna try and be really careful to take, because I kind of want you to see what the egg looks like. All shrunk and wet. Because remember, our egg was rubbery and it was kind of clear. I don't know if I can take this out gently without it. I don't want it to anything happen to it. But see how it's, I'll show it up close so you can see what it looks like, all shrunk, and it's kind of wrinkly. Do you see what it looks like? And then, the inside yolk is kind of hard. I know it's kind of hard to see on the camera, but when you do it in person at home, it's really cool and amazing. So that's what happens to our egg. See how it's like rubbery, still rubbery, but it shrunk because all the water came out. I know science can be a little messy. That's okay. It's okay because we can just clean it up. It's not a big deal. That's why we have sinks and paper towels. So that's what semi-permeability is. Really super cool. So then what you want to do on your sheet is you want to do what is happened after. So you want to show that your egg is shrunk and and that you can see the really cool yolk in there. It's kind of clear. That rubbery egg has shrunk. Because remember, our before picture is our big bubbling egg from our bubbling egg experiment. So that's why it's important you do your bubbling egg experiment first, because you have to use that egg to do this experiment. And again, both experiments take 72 hours, which is kind of a lot of time. You have to kind of be patient. So do your bubbling egg on Friday. Then by Monday morning, you'll be good to go, ready to use it. And so when you do this experiment on Monday, then again, by like Wednesday afternoon or maybe Thursday morning, you might want to maybe do it Thursday morning, you will have your shrinking egg. So it takes time, but it's amazing and it's so much fun. You guys are going to love it. All right, we'll see you later.